Hail the glorious liberation! From this week on, March the 29th will be known as Article 50 Day, and it will be compulsory every year on March the 29th to dance all day in a fountain. And Tottenham Court Road will be renamed Davis Place. And every year on Article 50 Day, we'll give each other presents that will be lovingly wrapped and left under a giant black pudding in the living room. And kids will drive their parents mad for weeks going, what am I going to get for Article 50 Day? What am I going to get for Article 50 Day? And old people will complain, well, the adverts for Article 50 Day start in the middle of January these days. It's ridiculous. Then we'll spend all afternoon feasting on liver bought by the ounce. And then a pile of foreigners will be put in a tub and spun round like in the thing that they use for an FA Cup draw. And a blindfolded Boris Johnson will drag one out and parade whoever they get through the streets under a statue of Michael Gove. And we'll all sing the new national anthem that goes, if you're from an EU court in some poxy Baltic court, then your verdict counts for naught, because we're British and we fought for the right to deport. Who will fucking well deport? Then they'll be dragged to Folkestone and put on a raft. And in Liam Fox Park, a 90-foot-high commemorative bendy banana will be used as a slide for kids. And at Dover Castle at noon, a 21-gun salute will fire beef dripping at the French. Because from this day on, history will regard the great figures who have dedicated their lives to building a nation as Nelson Mandela, Garibaldi, Gandhi and Chris Grayling. And it's right that it's called the Great Repeal Bill, sounding as glorious as one of Abraham Lincoln's laws abolishing slavery. And it should be full of phrases such as, the truth shall evermore be stated, that from this noble day, a nation that arose in magnificent splendour cast off its chains and grasped the light from the very heavens to state that no longer will we be barred from negotiating our own separate trade agreement with Canada on spring onions. In the evening, vicars will stand at the pulpit before their congregation shouting, we have been redeemed by Article 50. And the congregation will all shout back, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Lord, thank you for Article 50. And eventually, Article 50 will become a holy scripture itself, and in court, jurors and defendants will have to swear on Article 50 that it represents the truth, the whole truth, and enough truth to fill the side of a bus. Every morning in school, children in assembly will have to recite lines from Article 50 saying, I hereby notify the European Council in accordance. And if any of them aren't saying it with sufficient enthusiasm, then one of the other teachers will be able to drag them up to the headmaster's office and clout them round the head, which will now be legal because Europe will no longer be allowed to meddle in our values. If you suggest to anybody that leaving the EU might be a bit of a shame, you'll have Ramona painted across your door. And every year on Article 50 Day, you'll be dragged up Douglas Carswell Avenue. And citizens will fire fireworks at you, which will now be legal because all health and safety laws will have been burnt in a ceremony, filmed and broadcast live on BBC One and presented by David Starkey. Because at last we've got our country back, and instead of having to defer to elites, our decisions are now made by common, ordinary folk, people like Boris, one of our own Johnson, from the spit and sawdust wing of the Bullingdon Club, who may disappear for odd moments during the Brexit negotiations, but that's only because he's had to nip down the bookies to put a score on the dogs. This triumph for ordinary people is why Rupert Neveroff the dartboard Murdoch is so delighted. And this is why his newspaper, The Sun, is such a champion of the common person. And it's why it's particularly celebrated and popular in traditional working class cities like Liverpool. David Davis and Theresa May have suggested that we'll be in a stronger position with the EU having left than we were as members. And that should work because most institutions tend to give you far more favours when you're not a member than if you are. When you go to the supermarket, they say, have you got a loyalty card? And if you say no, then they give you a bucket of fresh salmon. If you say, yes, I have got a loyalty card, they squirt carpet cleaner in your eye. Now we've created an even better atmosphere with EU negotiators because we've said we'll only help them fight terrorism if they give us a deal on trade. And I mean, that makes perfect sense because if you agree to help somebody stop a terrorist act without making sure there's a few bob in it for yourself, you're just being a fool to yourself, aren't you? So let's celebrate our freedom. Let every boy born in 2017 be called Nigel. Let's make March the 29th the time when we dance through the night, because we have broken our chains and we have created our own freedom. We're no longer do we have to be told what to do by anybody else. Now we are free. Free to say, yes, Mr. Trump. Well, anything you say, Mr. Trump. We've got to sell something to someone. Please, Mr. Trump, please buy something off us, Mr. Trump. Please.